Greetings, New Zealand naturopath Eric Baker. Thanks for checking out my video again. I've got lots of questions, many questions from people all around the place. Here's an interesting question. Eric, can Candida cause sinusitis? Well, there's a huge link between sinus problems and yeast infections. So let's go into that a little bit. There was a very interesting study that was conducted. You can find it on the internet in 1999, the Mayo Clinic in the States, quite a well-known medical center. So what they did is they got a whole bunch of different people with sinus problems. In fact, 210 people in this particular study, they found 96% of 210 people who had chronic sinus problems for longer than 3 months, in fact, had up to three, if not more, different kinds of yeasts in, you know, the nasopharyngeal region, you know, in the different sinus passages when they checked them right out. So in all those 210 people, they found over 40 different types of yeasts, yeast kind of infections in those people. But on average, it was between, I think, 2 to 2.7 kinds of yeasts or fungi per person. 96%, that's a lot of people. You know, that's quite a high percentage, isn't it, when you think about it? There's a big link. So acute sinus problems will generally mean that you've had it for less than 3 months or you don't have it recurringly. A chronic sinus problem means you've had it for longer than 3 months duration or you continually get them back again. I had a sinus problem for 7 years, a while ago now, and thank goodness I got rid of my sinus problem. There's a big sinus connection with Candida. Don't forget it. So many people with chronic AFS, allergic fungal sinusitis, as we call it, very well have a high probability of having a yeast that's underpinning this infection. So ask yourself the question, if you've got chronic sinus, do you drink alcohol? Do you like sweet foods? Are you drawn to anything sweet or a high carbohydrate intake? You need to very carefully think about that. So the solution for chronic sinusitis is to really get rid of the infection. And your best way to do that, in my opinion, is to improve your digestive function, make the diet change, and ensure that you've got good, strong adrenal function. So good cortisol levels. Cortisol is the hormone produced by the adrenal gland. Having a powerful cortisol level and a balanced cortisol level will allow you to fight many different kinds of infections, which can often, you know, be a problem for people. If you get them recurringly, it means you've got a poor immune system. So have a think about it. Do you like sweet stuff? Have you got a sinus problem? Are you drawn to a chocolate bar or maybe some kind of alcohol or wine? Or I had a patient before who likes having vodka on a regular basis. And his naturopath said, look, vodka's quite okay to have. Well, vodka's a neutral spirit. Gin and vodka are fine to have. And they're not fine to have. If you've got a fungal infection, you've got to stop alcohol. Okay, to me it's the apex, the top, right up the top is alcohol. If you can't stop alcohol, click off the video now because I can't help you, sorry. All right, but if you're prepared, if you've got a sinus problem and if you want to get rid of it, you got to stop drinking alcohol for at least 6 to 12 months. That is if it's a chronic problem. All right, now some of my patients with sinusitis have had it for 10 years. Imagine having sinus for 10 years. That'd be enough to drive you nuts. I couldn't live like that. 7 years was enough for me. I mean, I'd done my jail time. 7 years, I just had to get out of jail, you know, because sinus problems is like a prison sentence. It screws up your life. You get facial pain. You get it recurringly. You find it hard to fly in airplanes or dive underwater because of the facial pressure. You'll be blowing your nose. You'll be constantly snorting and coughing up phlegm and sniffing phlegm. And then what does the doctor say? Oh, you need an antibiotic. Take this antibiotic, it will cure you. Yeah, right. Well, that's only the beginning of your problems. Once you start taking the Darth Vader of drugs, the antibiotic, that's a really big mistake with a sinus infection. All right? It just doesn't work. Check out my other videos, which I believe I have completed on sinus problems. I think I've done a few of them. The bottom line is you need to make the diet change. You need to treat the gut related issue that many people with sinus have, and if you keep swallowing all this stuff all the time, you'll end up with stomach problems, a post-nasal drip, so there's awful stuff dripping into the back of your throat. I'm going to do some more videos on sinusitis, but this video basically was, can Candida cause sinusitis? Yes, it can, and there's a high probability that it can cause sinusitis. So you do the intelligent approach and fix the cause. Thanks for tuning in.